Hi, I'm Chris Edwards. Welcome to this week's Tennis Warehouse vlog. Let's have a look at understanding string patterns this week. So I'm gonna have a variety of rackets here. Each one has a unique string pattern. Let's have a look and describe some of the benefits you can get out of each one. First up, I have what we call an open string pattern. And this is a 16-18 string pattern in this Vocal Organic Super G 8. This is the 300 gram version. And it's a fairly open string pattern. So you've got a couple of numbers going on right there. The first number, the 16, is referring to the main strings, and we call the main strings these strings that run from the throat of the racket up to the head of the racket. So the strings running through here, main strings, and then the strings running across the racket we call cross strings right there. So in this racket, it's a 16-18, so you have 16 total main strings, 18 total cross strings. Another popular open string pattern would be a 16-19, so that would be an additional of one extra cross string in the string pattern right there. And the advantage of a nice open string pattern like this is it gives a very open feel when you hit the ball. So you get easy access to pace and depth because you're not moving a lot of string mass to get the ball out of the racket. The more strings you're gonna put in the racket, the more it's gonna deaden the response. It's gonna be harder to move that mass of string. It's gonna make the ball drop a little shorter. This one's nice and open, so it's gonna send the ball nice and deep with good pace. And also with the large squares in the string pattern, it's going to, think of it like an off-road tire. It's really going to dig in, grab the ball, and it can spit it out with some nice spin too. So think of open string patterns, anything with a 16 main and an 18 or 19 cross string setup is going to give you a livelier, more forgiving, and a more spin-friendly response. So those are things that you really want to add to your game, a bit of pace, some nice comfort too, and some good access to spin. Open string pattern, great way to go. Now conversely, right here in this Babolat Pure Control 95 Plus, exclusively available at Tennis Warehouse, this is an 18-20 string pattern racket. And what this one is a very dense, now you've got a lot of string material to move when you hit the ball. So you've got 18 mains, 20 crosses. You notice the holes in this one, the squares, much smaller. It's a really good option if you're a flatter hitter because as you drive the ball flatly, you don't have to spin to get the ball to drop in the court. The denser string pattern is going to take a little bit of the depth out of the ball. It's going to help you stay aggressive and keep the ball and get it to drop. I really like a dense string pattern on a slice shot too. I just like the way it gives me a lot of feel. I can really control the depth of my slice. I can really knife through with more racket head speed without fear of hitting long because I get some nice control from the dense string pattern. So you want a high level of control, you can go with a dense string pattern. Also, if you're really looking to lower string tension, dense string pattern is the way to go because it offers so much control from the density of the string pattern that you can really drop tension low and the ball's not gonna fly out of the racket and you're not gonna lose any control. So ultimate control from the dense string pattern. Something that's right in between is this Yonex Torji, and this is the lighter weight of the two versions. And this one has a 16-20. So you've got the 20 cross strings for a little bit of control, but you've got the 16 mains, so you get a little bit more spin than you would from an 18-20, but you get a little bit more control than you would from, say, a 16-18 or 16-19. It's becoming one of my favorite string patterns, the 16-20, because it really does blend both very, very well. I find the control I like on my flatter shots, and I get nice spin when looking to add some rotation to the ball too. So that's a great way to go right there if you want a kind of the best of both worlds approach. Next up, we have one of the biggest stories out there at the moment right now in racket technology is spin and string patterns specifically designed to offer spin. This is the 6195S. This is actually my racket of choice. And this one features an 18-16 string pattern. So it has 18 mains, 16 crosses, and you'll notice that this one actually has more main strings than cross strings. It's the only racket we've looked at. And that's a patented Wilson technology, is their spin effect string pattern. And what it is designed to do is with less cross strings coming across the racket, it's gonna let the mains slide a bit more. And when the mains, especially with a poly, slide and then snap back, that snap back right there, as the string snaps back, enables to give the ball a little kick and an extra spin, and it really does work. You can get a lot of spin on the ball out of these spin effect rackets. They come in a variety of different string patterns. I really like the 18, 16, because I get that control from the 18 mains. Don't have to worry about depth control as much with this, but I still get the advantage of less cross strings for more spin. So it's a great option right there. Check out Wilson's lineup for more spin effect options. And then Prince also has the ESP rackets, and that's extreme string pattern rackets. And what these do is just offer a very, very open pattern. And again, it's going to let the strings move. It's very open, so it's going to really let the ball sink into the string bed, grab it like a, you know, an off-road tire with the dirt, and really spit it out with a lot of spin. And so this one has 14 mains, I believe 16 crosses in this. So it's a really open, very, very spin-friendly offering right there from Prince. Hopefully that's cleared up some of the myths around string pattern for you, and I'll catch you next time.